we have here is a model of a human vertebral column. You can see that it's composed of 7 cervical vertebrae, 12 thoracic vertebrae, and then 5 stout lumbar vertebrae. You can see the tendency to get wider as we go downward. And the curvature. When we're born, and you know that babies sag in our arms, we're all curved, we would say concave anteriorly, like this, the way a baby sags in its mother's arms. When we get to be about, 2 months old, we were able to lift up our head and we developed an opposite curve in the cervical region. When we were about 6 months old, we were able to sit up and we developed an opposite curve in the lumbar region. The original thoracic curvature and the original sacral curvature remain throughout life. You can see that we've got cushioning intervertebral discs that are made of fibrocartilage, like the rubber of a rubber shoe, very, very sturdy and strong, but also resilient. You can also see that the spinal nerves exit from what we call intervertebral foramina. That's holes between two adjacent foramen. And then these vertebral bones in the thoracic region also attach the ribs. So quite a big job that's done here by the wonderful vertebral column. What I would like to do is show you some real vertebral columns and then some individual bones. These two are dried bones, real bones, and they've been in the lab for a number of years. They're probably at least 50 years old here. When I heft this one versus this one, of course that's hanging there, sort of dangling, this feels heavier. It really has a heavier feel, and I want to show you something if we can look up close here. When I take this bony material called the body of the vertebrae, I can see that the bony sponge, called spongy bone or cancellous bone, is very, very fine. I can hardly see the sponge. Yet when I take this other one and take the same bone, it's all full of holes, osteoporosis. This particular individual had much more osteoporosis, and you can literally see the holes in the bone. And when I heft it, it just is considerably lighter in weight. Nevertheless, these are very, very useful to us. Let me first show you the sacrum that attaches. This is the posterior side that attaches to the two coxal bones. We can see that there's an opening in it that attaches the end of the membranes around the spinal cord. And then there are foramina, that means openings, again, for spinal nerves. Here's an anterior view, in other words, a view if the person's face were facing the camera. And this, again, is posterior. I want to show you the individual bones. What we have here is the very first cervical vertebrae called atlas. Notice there's no body in it, as you can clearly see in these other ones. An easy way to remember it is Atlas, the mythical hero. This bone is named for Atlas, the mythical hero, who held the whole world on his shoulders. Do you know why he did that? Because nobody else would. Second in line is Axis. Let me turn Axis here for you. It has a dens or tooth, and we rotate our head no as we rotate axis around atlas. Let me see if I can do that for you. I'm doing no, but yes, I can. Cervical vertebrae are slender. They have an extra foramen in them. This is anterior, this is posterior. An extra foramen, that means an opening that guards the two vertebral arteries that go to our brain. And then the opening that you see here is for the spinal cord. The spinal cord is wonderfully protected by the vertebral column. It gives us flexible protection. That's a cervical vertebra. Let me pick up one of the 12 thoracic vertebrae. This is one of the 12 thoracic vertebrae. It's got the foramen, or opening, for the spinal cord. It's a little bigger than a cervical vertebra. And I can see when I look on it, just a little spot there and there. This spot is where a rib would articulate twice, like that. This is the spine, the spinous process. That's why it's called a spine. Your cervical vertebrae, slightly bigger body. Generally easy to identify a lumbar vertebra. It's got a stout body and a square spinous process. The attachments are for the erector spinae muscles, and there are attachments, as on the other ones, for the vertebra above and the vertebra below. Again, the spinal cord located there.